Good afternoon, students. In this session, we have to discuss the first chapter, Solid State. I have to teach some topics in this chapter. So the first topic is the characteristics of the solid solids. Before we going to talk about these characteristics of the solids, we must learn the what are the solids and where these solids came from. We need to clarify that what are the solids. We must learn the what actually matter. So matter is observed in the nature. We are living in the nature. In the nature, many objects are available in the form of matter. So then, what is meant by the matter? So matter is referred as anything that occupies. Space and has mass. So a matter is referred as anything that occupies space and has mass. So any object you have to take, so it having some mass, so then it is placed on any object, it occupying some space. So for example, you have to take a book or a piece of chalk. For example, you have to piece of chalk. So then the piece of chalk is taken. It has more mass, so it is placed on the table. So it occupying some space. So anything or any object, so it has some mass, so it placed on anything, so it occupying some space. So that is the card has the matter. So then the matter is available in three forms. So you already know in earlier classes. So then which forms are available in the matter? So the matter exists in three forms. So matter exists in three forms. So what are the forms? So states of matter. So the matter exists in three forms. Those are solids, liquids, and gases. So the matter exists in three forms: solids, liquids, and gases. So then, why matter exists in these three forms? So then the matter exists in three forms: solids, liquids, and gases. It's only depending upon the two factors. So that two factors are the one is intermolecular attractive forces. Intermolecular attractive forces, and next one is thermal energy. So these two factors which influences the substances, the matter, it will be the in three forms: solids or liquids and gases. Later we discuss these two factors. Now we have to talk about the what need of the study. So what is the need of study of the solids? So need of study of solids. So the main reason is we are mostly surrounded by the solids. So then how to identify that we are mostly surrounded by the solids? So the basic example you already learned the periodic table in earlier classes. In the periodic table, so most of the elements are available in the form of the solids. So only rare elements are available in the form of the gaseous and liquid forms. So for example, in which elements are available in liquid forms? So hydrazinum, for example, hydrazinum and bromine are available in liquid forms, and in gaseous states are hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So those elements are exist in the form of the gaseous forms. So remaining all elements, are available in the form of the solids. So for example, alkali metals, alkaline earth metals, transition elements. So in a transition elements, so those are remaining, exception of these elements, remaining of the solid forms. So then applications of the next, we have to discuss the applications of solids. So applications of solid substances. Solids. So we are mostly surrounded by the solids. So in our everyday life, we are using the most of the substances form of solid substance when compared to the liquids and solid substance, liquids and gaseous substances. So then based on the structure and properties of the solid substances, so that's why solid substances are mostly used. For example, we are using the high temperature superconductors, biodegradable polymers, magnetic substances, and so everything, cooking brushes, so and also bench and iron rods. So many most of the objects are available in the solid form. So that's why we are mostly using the solid substance when compared to the liquids and gaseous substances. So and next, now we have to talk about the comparison of solids and liquids and gaseous substances. So comparison of solids, liquids and gases. So how to comparison of solids and the liquids and the gaseous substances. It depending on some properties are to be used to identify which substances are solids, which substances are liquids, and which substances are gaseous substances. Before we are comparison of this distinction of solids and liquids and the gaseous substance, then I can draw the diagrams of the solids and liquids and the gaseous substances structures. So the solids and the liquids and gaseous substances structures. So solids, liquids and gaseous substances. In these solid substances, the particles are arranged very close to each other. So compact structure is here in the solid substances. In the liquid substances, the constituted particles are arranged in this type of manner. So in the gaseous substances, the constituted particles are arranged in this manner. So you see these pictures, it is very near to each other, so very very tightly packing. So in the liquid substances, most of the distances are appeared. So when compared to this, high distances are there. So then which properties are to be used to identify the which substances are solids, which substances are liquids, which substances are gaseous. So the properties, solids, liquids and gaseous. So the first property is packing efficiency. So packing efficiency, that means the arrangement of the constituted particles in the solids. the constituted particles are very very near to each other, very closely packing. So that means it is very closely packing. So that means tightly packing the constituted particles in these solid substances. In the liquid substances, the constituted particles are loosely packing. So then gaseous substances very loosely packing. So loosely packing. So and then next property is shape. So then in solid substance it having the definite shape. So definite shape. So in liquids also definite based on the equation definite shape. So and the gaseous are the shapeless. So remaining properties are, so property in solids, liquids, gaseous. So remaining properties are value in solids are definite value, in liquids also definite value based on the container. So then the gaseous based on the pressure, based on the pressure. So solids having the definite their definite volume, liquids also definite volume. So gaseous are the pressure based on the pressure. So and then compressibility. So compressibility, then in the solids incompressible. So it is difficult to compressible because of, so the structure of solid substances, the particles are very tightly packing. So it is unable to compress it. So that's why so solids are incompressible. So liquids are less compressible because of loosely packing structure. So less compressible. In gaseous substance are highly compressible, very most spaces is there. So that's why we can apply the pressure. So it is highly compressible. So highly compressible. So our last one is the attractive forces. So then in the solid substances, attractive forces are stronger. So that's why the solid substances are definite shape, rigid manner. So in liquids has less stronger forces. So then gaseous substances are weak attractive forces. So these properties, packing efficiency, volume, compressibility, attractive forces, these the properties are to be used to identify which substances are solids and liquids and gaseous substances. Among these reasons, when the liquids and the gases are called as fluids. So why the liquids and the gases are called as fluids? So fluid means to able to move. So the liquids and the gaseous, so ability always to the nature is the flowing nature. Then because of these, for example, so then the liquids and the gases are called as the fluids. So that means the ability to move. So for example, well known example, you have to take a bucket of water. So then it is a bucket of water, it is then water, it is overflowing or it is transferred to the transport on the flow. So it is traveling. So always in flowing nature. So always water is the type of liquid. So liquid substances are always to be flowing from high surface to low surfaces. So always it having the flowing nature. And the gaseous substance also having the flowing nature. So then how to identify? I have to give one common example. So your mummy is prepared a delicious food in the kitchen. So you're not presence. So your presence and one of the room in the house. But you sense the flavor of the food. So the reason is that so the gas the flavor is in the form of the gaseous form is to be traveled to or flowing to one place to another place. So that's why liquids and the gases are able to move. So let's see the one question. So that is the how do liquids and gases how possess liquids and gases possess fluidity. Why do solids possess rigidity? So these are two questions. So why do liquids and gases possess fluidity? Why do solids possess rigidity? So then the first question. So liquids and gases possess fluidity. We are discussing in this above. So liquids and gases the possess fluidity. That fluidity that means tendency to flow. Fluidity that means tendency to flow. So then the liquids and the gases tend always tendency to flow because of the structures of the liquids and the gases. The constituted particles are very loosely packed. So intermolecular distances are more. So when the intermolecular distances are more, so then it is to be able to move. Attractions are very weak. So that's why these are able to move. So when the liquids and the gases possess fluidity because of the loosely packing of constituent particles. So why do solids possess rigidity? So then in solid structure, the particles or molecules are arranged in the closely packing. So when the closely packing, that means the distance are very shorter from one molecule to another molecule. So then distance are very shorter, attractive forces is more. The attractive forces is the molecules, when the attractive forces is acting, when the molecules are come close together, so then it gets the definite shape and definite volume, so which is nothing but the rigidity. So then now we have to discuss then why do matter exists in three forms. Why do matter exists in these three forms? That means liquids, solids and gases. So at before I already told. So then the matter exists in three forms based on the two opposing factors. So that two opposing factors which are, so the first one is the intermolecular attractive forces, and next one is thermal energy. So how to these two factors influences the matter is exists in the three forms. So let me clarify that. So first one is intermolecular attractive forces. under molecular attractive forces. So then it defined as the then or the intermolecular forces are the forces are always tends to keep the molecules keeps the constituent particles such as atoms or ions or molecules come close together. Particles are come close to each other. So then intermolecular attractive forces are the forces or always tends to keep the molecules or tends to keep the constituent particles such as atoms or ions to molecules or come close to each other. That means when making the substances either a solid or a liquid or a gaseous substances, so some of the attractive forces is acting in between the one molecule to another molecules. So where the attractive forces always the molecules to keeps to come close to together. So that forces are called as the intermolecular attractive forces. Then how the intermolecular attractive forces influences the solids in liquids and gaseous substances. So then if you observe in the solid substances, in liquid substances and the gaseous substances. So in liquid solid substances, in gaseous forms, then it is a very closely packing of constituent particles. So in liquids most of the distance will be appeared. So in gaseous substance the very most distance is there. So then when the shorter distance is appeared in between the two molecules are completed over the molecules, these distances are very shorter. So the strong intermolecular attractive forces, that means the very strong intermolecular attractive forces. So strong intermolecular attractive forces is here in the solid substances. In the liquid substances, the molecules are the distances are more when one molecule to another molecule. When the distances are more, the attractive forces are very less. So attractive forces are very less. That's why the liquids are always to be loosely packing. Attraction are very less. So it is loosely packing, it is able to move. So then in gaseous substances, so the particles are the most distances is appeared in the gaseous substances structure. So that's why attractions are very very weaker when compared to the solids and liquids. So then now we have to talk about the thermal energy. So what is meant by the thermal energy? Thermal energy is the energy possessed by the constituent particles such as atoms or ions or molecules due to temperature. So a thermal energy is the energy possessed by the constituted particles, either atoms or molecules or ions, is due to temperature. So that means then what it doing the thermal energy? The thermal energy makes the constituted particles to move freely. So it influences the movement of the particles. So thermal energy influences the movement of the particles. So then it is always directly proportional to temperature. When the thermal energy is directly proportional to temperature, when the temperature is increases, thermal energy is increases. That means thermal energy is increases, movement of constituent particles also increases. Movement of constituent particles also increases. So, and also thermal energy is directly proportional to temperature, and also thermal energy is opposed to intermolecular attractive forces. So thermal energy directly proportional to temperature. So thermal energy also opposes to intermolecular attraction forces. When temperature is increases, thermal energy is increases. That means movement of the constituted particles also increases. When thermal energy is also opposes to intermolecular attractive forces, then how it is happens in the solid and the gaseous and the liquid substances. The liquid substances and gaseous salts. So, in these liquid substances, the constituted particles are most distance will appear. So, it is a high distances when compared to the liquids, high distances. Solids are compact structure. So, very compact structure. So, compact structure. So, in the liquids, we consider these liquids. So, the distances are more. So, when the distances are high, the lesser attractive forces. When the lesser attractive forces at given temperature, then the at given temperature is increases, then thermal energy is also increases. Then, the intermolecular attractive forces is lesser. Intermolecular attractive forces is lesser. So, because of distances are more. When the distance are slightly more at given temperature, so temperature is given, so thermal energy is increases. That means movement of the particle is increases. Then the liquid substance is always in flowing nature, so that means thermal energy is higher. So when temperature at given temperature, so thermal energy is increases. Because of the movement of the particle is increases in the liquid particles, because of intermolecular attractions are lesser. In the gaseous substances at given temperature, so distances are very very more. So distances are very very more, then attractive forces are very weaker. So attractive forces are weaker. So when the attractive forces are weaker, so thermal energy is more. Thermal energy is more. So thermal energy is more, so movement of the particle also more. In the solid substances, the solids always form at low temperature. So low temperature, because of the solid substances particles, then at low temperature, so low thermal energy. So thermal energy, temperature is low, thermal energy is also low. So thermal energy is low, movement also low. So when the distance are very shorter, so then the attractions are more. Attractions are more. So stronger. Attractions are stronger. So when the attractions are stronger, so then the distance are very shorter, so that's why attractions are stronger. So attractions are stronger when the particles are come close together, it fixed at one position. So it unable to moving, but it oscillate about the mean position. So that's why thermal energy is low in the solid forms, because of that low temperature. At low temperature, so attractions are more. So in gaseous substances, thermal energy is more because of attractions are weaker. So in the liquid substances, then intermolecular attractive forces are lesser because of thermal energy is more. So next, we have to discuss the characteristics of the solids. Characteristics of solids. Characteristics of solids. So the first characteristic is, among above all these reagents, then stories having the definite characteristics. Then what are the characteristics? Let's see. First characteristic is solids are definite shape, mass, volume. So solids are forming, formation of solids occurs at always low temperature. So at low temperature, the constituent particles, constituent particles set into fixed positions. Set into fixed positions, come close to yellow at low temperature. So the constituent particles are low temperature. That means the low thermal energy. So low thermal energy automatically attractive forces are more stronger. So when the more attractive forces are more stronger, the constituent particles are set into be a fixed position. So that's why it having definite shape and definite value. So then it is a rigid manner. So then another character is solids are incompressible. And rigid manner. Why the solids are incompressible and rigid manner? So as the same above reason. So because of incompressible, because of the particles or the constituent particles are set into fixed position. When this is set into fixed position, so when the utter distances are very lesser. So then attraction forces are very strong at low temperature. Then the thermal energy is also low. That means attraction forces are very strong. When the attractive forces are stronger, the constituted particles are come close together. So that's why these are said to be a fixed position. So it having the definite shape and mass and the volume. It is unable to moving the particles because of it is closely packing. So it is unable to, we can apply any pressure. For example, you have to take a stone. So it, when we apply the pressure on it, so it is unable to, you try to compress it, it is very difficult to compress it. So that's why solid substances are incompressible because of the compact structure. So the particle more stronger attractive forces is there. So the constituted particles are set into a fixed position. So then it having the definite shape and definite value. So then it has nothing but rigid manner. So then the first, next characteristic is definite high density. So these solid substances having the high density. So the reason is that the higher masses when compared to liquids and gases. So when compared to liquids and the gaseous substances, solids are the higher masses. So higher masses substances are always to be having the higher density. So and last characteristic is the constituent particles oscillate about the mean position. So already we discussed this point. So then the structure of the solids, so stronger attractive forces is there. So shorter distances, stronger attractive forces. Then the stronger attractive forces, the molecules are to become close together, so then it is unable to moving the constituted particles, but it also oscillate about their mean position. So then the constituted particles are oscillate about their mean position. The region is the compact structure. So then the hope you understood, students. Thank you.